डियर चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू आर फाइन. सो इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव स्टार्टेड हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 2 फ्रॉम ट्रेड टू टेरिटरी. सो व्हाट वी हैव स्टार्टेड इन लास्ट वीडियो, हिस्ट्री चैप्टर 2 फ्रॉम ट्रेड टू टेरिटरी. ओके, सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू दैट लेसन. Okay, children, so this video contains small topic from trade to territory lesson. Okay, children, so let's start. Okay. So how trade led to battles? So this British companies, they started trading in India. How this trade led to battles? How that led to war? Okay. So the conflict between the company and the Nawabs of Bengal started. So what started conflict? Some misunderstanding, some problems between company, the British company, and the Nawabs of Bengal. So first they started trade in Bengal, right? So Nawabs of Bengal means rulers ruling that Bengal. Between them and company, they have started conflict. Okay, children. So the Bengal Nawabs refused to grant the company concessions, demanded large tributes for the company right to trade, and denied it any right to mint coins and stopped it from extending its fortifications. So what happened? This Bengal Nawabs, they were asking more and more concessions, that means more and more gifts, to accept that company's right in India. Okay, and they didn't allow any of its extending that company. Okay, so they were asking more and more concessions, okay, from the company, so that they will allow the company to trade. Okay, so in that they started misunderstanding. Okay, they also claimed that the company was depriving the Bengal government of huge amounts of revenue and undermining the authority of the Nawab. So what happened? They also told like this company that was making many revenue from Bengal government, that also dominating this Bengal government, that company started dominating this Bengal government. So these all problems, these all misunderstandings between Bengal government and the company, British company, entered in one big battle. Okay, that is very very famous battle, that is called Battle of Plassey. Say together with me, what is that battle? Battle of Plassey. So this is very 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 famous battle in history of British in India. Okay, so what is the battle name? Battle of Plassey. Okay, children, so this Battle of Plassey, as I told, it is very very important in Indian history. You should remember that date. Okay, not date, that year. Okay, children, as we studied in the previous lessons, dates were very important, and according to the importance of the date, that date become important. Okay, that means that important event happened in that date makes the date important. Okay, in 1757, Robert Clive led two companies army against Rajadivila at Plassey. So in which year, children? 1957. Robert Clive, so he led the army against Sirajuddin at Plassey. Okay, so who led the Battle of Plassey? Robert Clive, in the year 1757. Okay, the main reason for the defeat, so in that battle, in the Battle of Plassey, the Bengal government was defeated. Okay, so this is India, and in Bengal government has many power, and they are like the strong. Okay, they are native, but how this British company, that they are from different country, right? So how they came to this place and they won? So there might be some strong reason, right? So the reason is forces led by Mir Jafar. Okay, forces led by Mir Jafar. Mir Jafar, he is what we term Sirajuddinullah. That man, he accepted company's promises. So company promised, like, if you be quiet in the battle, if you be quiet in the battle, and if you never fought in the battle, we will make you as the Nawab of Bengal. Okay, so you just be quiet and just watch what is happening. Okay, this Mir Jafar accepted that promise and he stayed quiet in the battle, and because of that, who won? The company won. Okay, so Mir Jafar helped the company to win that battle. So this Battle of Plassey became very famous because it is the first major victory of the company in India. So these are like general knowledge questions also. So which battle is the first major victory of the company in India? So which was the battle? Battle of Plassey. Okay, that was the first major victory of the company in India. Next, look, the first picture, Robert Clive, and second, Mir Jafar. So who is Mir Jafar? Mir Jafar is the one who helped the company to win the battle. Next, the prime objective of the company was the expansion of trade. So what was their main objective? To expansion of trade, to expand the trade, to develop the trade. So it can first, what they were did means they were doing their trade with the help of local rulers in India. And after that, they understood like it's little difficult to expand the trade with the help of local rulers. So they thought to take the control of that place. In 1765, the Mughal emperor appointed the company as the Diwan of the provinces of Bengal. So in 1765, what happened? The Mughal emperor, he appointed the company as the Diwan, main power of that province. Then it allowed the company to use vast revenue resources of Bengal. Next, from the early 18th century, the company trade expanded, developed. So when the company's trade expanded, from the early 18th century, goods from India had to be brought with gold and silver imported from Britain. So like goods are exported from India to Britain, some goods are imported from Britain to India, like gold and silver. Okay, children. So next, company officials become Nawabs. So Nawabs is same like Nawab. Okay. But the British people cannot pronounce same as we pronounce, right? So they just tried to pronounce Nawab and they pronounce like Nabob. Okay, so these both are having same meaning, this Nawabs and Nawabs, same meaning, but Nabob is the anglicized version of Nawab. After the Battle of Plassey, the company officials forced the actual Nawabs of Bengal to give land and vast sums of money as personal gifts. So what happened? After the Battle of Plassey, the company officials, okay, big people in the big position in the company, they forced the Nawabs of Bengal, rulers of Bengal, to give land and big amount of money as a gift to them. When Robert Clive left India, his Indian fortune was worth more than 4 lakh. Okay, he earned more than 4 lakh. Then in 1764, this Robert Clive was appointed as the governor of Bengal and was asked to remove the corruption in the administration. Next, many company officials, they died in India because of disease and some because of war. Okay, many company officials, they died in India because of disease and some because of war. And some officials, they came to India to earn more in India and return to Britain and lead a comfortable life. First point, to earn more in India, then return to their motherland, Britain, and lead a comfortable and wonderful life. Those who managed to return with wealth were called Nabobs. They were called as Nabobs. Okay? Nabobs means that anglicized version of the Indian word Nawab, same meaning of Nawab. So thank you children, thank you for listening. So that's all for today's video. The remaining of this lesson we will see in the next video. Thank you children, have a nice day.